In this lecture, I will make another 3D text effect, using tiling, to easily create a pattern. I click on the text tool, and type, 3D text. I use Shrikehand, which is a free Google font. I duplicate the text, and drag it below. I double-click on it, to get to the text tool. I press Ctrl+A, and type, Inkscape. I click on the select tool. I hold Ctrl and drag the right side in, to match the size of the text above. Now I drag the text above to the right, so that the T and the E show a straight line. I would like to have some curvature in the text. To do this, I have to convert the text to paths. I select them both, and go to Path, Object to Path. To curve 3D text, I go to Path Effects. From the menu I choose, Envelope Deformation. I click on the Edit on Canvas button, at the right of bottom bend path. Now I see a green line at the bottom of the text. I can drag the line, to curve the text at the bottom. Now let's curve the text below. I go to Path Effects, and choose, Envelope Deformation. I select the Edit on Canvas button, at the right of top bend path. I control drag the left node up. And I drag the green line down. I also control drag the right node up. I drag the green line down again. I see, I can drag the left node a bit further up. And I can drag the green line a bit further down. I want to compress the text a bit, so I select them both. I drag the text, a bit in. To finalize the effect, I go to Path, Object to Path. Now I will make them a single path. I want the 3D effect, to go from light blue to a darker blue. I duplicate the text, and give it a darker blue. I hold Shift and Control, and make the duplicate smaller. I shift click on the larger text. I want to create a transition from one path, to the other. I go to Extensions, Generate from Path, Interpolate between paths. I will make 50 copies in between them, and click on Live Preview. I click on Apply, and on Close. In my layers, I see a new group, which are the transitioning paths. I will place the original light blue text, on top. And I will make it dark blue. I call the path, Top Text. I duplicate Top Text, and call it, Pattern. I go to Fill and Stroke, and for the fill, I choose, Pattern. For my pattern, I choose, Abstract 1. Now I will make my own pattern. I click on the ellipse tool. I hold Ctrl, and drag a small circle. I go to Path Effects. I choose, Tiling. I will make 30 rows, and 60 columns. To get smaller circles at the top, and larger circles at the bottom, I set scale to 7%. And I want to shift each row 50%, so I set offset to 50. I zoom out, and I will size the pattern to fit the text. I will make the pattern white. To get the pattern covering the 3D effect, I right-click on the group, and choose, Set Clip Group. I name the pattern, Circles. I drag circles, on the clip group. I set the opacity of circles to 25%. With my arrow keys, I now choose which part I like best of the circles. I can also resize, to get larger or smaller circles. I will create a black background. I click on the rectangle tool, and drag over the canvas. I press the spacebar, and click on lower to bottom. To make the edges visible, I will add some strokes. I duplicate top text. In my swatches, I click on none. And I shift click on white. At the bottom right, I scroll backwards, to set the stroke to half a millimeter. I call the path, white. I duplicate the path twice. I call the top layer blue, and shift click on the light blue swatch. I hide blue. I click on white, go to fill and stroke paint. I set blur to 10%. I call the path, white blur. I shift click on white, and choose, group. I drag the group a bit down. I reveal blue, and scale it from the bottom.